All right. Hey, thanks for coming out tonight. Appreciate you guys coming out and supporting the fine arts here. Also, there was a Ford key fob that was found. If it's yours, it's back at the sound booth. If it, no one claims it, we're going to go. The PTO is going to take it, and we're going to raffle it off. So that would be a little fundraiser for us. So thank it doesn't matter what year. Anyways.
Is it newer than mine?
Yeah. Anyways, thanks for coming out and supporting the fine arts. And before we get started, let's give Miss Nelson a round of applause for all the work that she does.
Thank you.
All right. Hi, everybody. If you haven't met me yet, I'm Molly Nelson. I'm the music teacher here at Neil Armstrong and also at John Glenn. I just want to say a couple things. I'll be real fast. I just want to thank all the teachers for being flexible with me over the past couple weeks, doing extra rehearsals and things like that. It really helps it come together today. So today isn't the first time we're all singing together in a group. And Mr. Green, thank you for all your support. I really appreciate that. Just a quick reminder to turn your cell phones to silent, which I just realized in this moment I didn't do to my own, so I will do that in a second. Also, same thing he said about supporting the fine arts. I really appreciate you making tonight a priority. Your kids only have one music program in a school year, and music is a class in our school day, and they do get a grade. So I really appreciate you showing them that their schooling is a priority. So thank you for being here. In the song Do Re Mi, you're going to hear them singing something we call solfege or solfa, okay? And we have little hand symbols that go with them. Hold on. Okay, so you're gonna see them doing hand symbols that go along with this. This is something they'll do all the way up through high school, and if they continue on in music beyond high school, they'll probably do it in that as well. And that's true of band and orchestra, not just choir. So it's something that they will use all the way through. We are going to have, at the end of the show, we're going to get all the kids off the stage and back to the commons where you dropped them off or sent them at the beginning. If you could come and pick them up there and check out with their teacher, just so we make sure they get home safely to the correct people, we'd really appreciate it. Before we start, we are going to have Elise Wilson and Bree Rexroth come read to you for a moment.
My name is Bree.
And my name is Elise.
We are some of the young performers tonight.
Neil Armstrong's three pillars are be safe, be responsible, and be respectful.
I don't know how to pronounce this word.
Please demonstrate this life skill of respectfulness by keeping your voices down during our performance.
We want to make sure that you have the best experience possible for our performance today.
Because your kids' talent is really quite neat.
We've been working hard for weeks, and now we want you to know
that Neil Armstrong's got talent, so enjoy the show.
Do you hear that beat? It's the sound of people entering the theater on the most famous street in the world.
Do you hear that beat? It's the sound of dancing feet and orchestras turning up.
Did you hear that beat? It's the sound of Rodgers and Hammerstein.
Lerner and Lowe.
Stephen Sondheim and Stephen Schwartz.
It's the sound of Oklahoma.
The King and I.
Wicked.
Fiddler on the Roof.
Do you hear that beat? It's the sound that dreams are made of.
Do you hear that beat? It's the sound of Broadway.
And nobody can stop it.
Stop my
That's right. You can't stop the beat on Broadway.
Speaking of Broadway, do you know who is known as the father of American musical comedy?
Why, sure. That was George M. Cohen.
That's right. Do you know what the M stands for?
Maestro?
Nope.
Mario?
Hardly.
Marcello?
Not even close. George M. Cohen was a playwright, composer, entertainer, lyricist, actor, singer, dancer, and producer.
Marcus?
His first big hit was Little Johnny Jones, a story about an American jockey who went to England to ride his Yankee Doodle in the Derby.
Macaroni.
So here's our salute to Mr. George Michael Cohen.
Michael, I knew that. I knew that.
A new show hit the Broadway stage.
It was written by Meredith Wilson. It was a con man named Harold Hill who pretended to be a band director and sell expensive band uniforms and instruments to the people of River City, Iowa.
The show was a huge hit. It won 5 Tony Awards, the highest honor for a Broadway show. Do you hear that beat? It's the best of marching feet and 76 trombones.
It's the sound of the Music Man.
Let the morning sun light. Rodgers and Hammerstein were two of the greatest writers of Broadway shows.
They wrote such classics as Oklahoma, South Pacific, Carousel, and The King and I.
In 1959, Rodgers and Hammerstein wrote a musical based on the memoir of Maria von Trapp, the story of the Trapp family singers.
The show was called The Sound of Music, and one of the most popular songs in it was called Do Re Mi.
Wicked was written by Stephen Schwartz and debuted on Broadway in 2003.
But his success began long before that. He wrote Gospel shortly after graduating college, and at the young age of 23, Stephen Schwartz was an instant success.
Seeing a great Broadway show, seeing a great Broadway song, or even performing in a Broadway show can change you.
Just like making a new friend can change you.
For the better.
Maybe.
For the worse.
Perhaps.
Forever?
Well, maybe not forever, but certainly for good.
In 1996, the rock musical Rent hit Broadway.
The show went on to win four Tony Awards.
And ran on Broadway for 12 years.
The Broadway Beat is a rhythm of life that could take us on fantastic adventures, exploring feelings that sometimes only music can capture.
First shows opened in the early 1800s, the Broadway Beat has been pounding steadily.
And it doesn't show signs of slowing down.
It takes a lot of effort to put on a Broadway show. The most successful ones are the shows where all the pieces come perfectly together.
Let's go together to Broadway, where every day and every night, the beat goes on.
Take, 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 take you up. Now it's me.
right, give it up for Mrs. Hilmer's class. Here we go. And Mrs. Burke's class. And Miss Nelson's class. And Mrs. Bowman's class. And Mrs. Ballard's class. Oh, careful. And Mrs. Ryder's class. Last but not least, Mr. Ayer's class. As I said before, let us get all the kids off the stage and back to the commons, and then you may come and collect them. Thank you so much for coming. I hope you enjoyed the show. And now those songs are officially stuck in your head. You're welcome. Have a great night.